on shopping, and I don't think she has Honey installed on her computer. I need to put an end to this. Wait, Mom, before you check out, do you have Honey installed?
What's Honey?
Oh, no. It's a free browser add-on that automatically applies coupon codes when you check out online.
So what's the catch?
There is no catch. My mom wants to buy these three jackets online. They cost $639. Before you check out, Mom, can you just open a new tab and then type in joinhoney.com? Now just click add to Chrome. Perfect, now hit apply coupon code. Give Honey 5 seconds and boom, it found a coupon code for $221. We're literally about to check out without Honey. That is a sin. I have a challenge for all of you. Go to every computer in your house, your mom's, your dad's, your sister, your brother's computer, and install Honey. It's free and only takes 2 clicks to install. There's no reason not to go to joinhoney.
Melissa, can you hear me?
I can. Yeah.
Okay.
I think we just lost the end of it, but
we did, and that's okay. At least we saw the beginning. So now people can go back and find Mr. Beast.
Yeah.
Oh, there we go. Here we go.
Give Honey 5 seconds and boom, it found a coupon code for $221. We're literally about to check out without Honey. That is a sin. I have a challenge for all of you. Go to every computer in your house, your mom's, your dad's, your sister, your brother's computer, and install Honey. It's free and only takes 2 clicks to install. There's no reason not to go to joinhoney.com right now on every computer in your house.
I love him.
There we go. Welcome everyone to our session, Diversify Beyond Social. Curate an offer to match your brand values and leverage reward solutions to distribute it. We hope you enjoyed our influencer video. I apologize, it was a little glitchy there, but it walked you through how Honey helps users save time and money. My name is Jen Goodwin, and I'm the Director of Partnerships for Honey. I'm thrilled to also introduce you to an industry veteran with me today, Melissa Feemster. Melissa is co-founder of Team Bespoke, an agency that specializes in helping new and emerging D2C brands enter the affiliate marketing space. Prior to co-founding Team Bespoke, Melissa was the general manager of Rakuten, one of the largest affiliate networks, and she also had 2 very successful exits from startups. I should also note, Melissa and I are personal friends as well as professional. We've had quite a few dinners with our husbands and many laughs. So Melissa, you're currently running many D2C programs across several verticals in the affiliate marketing space, correct?
Yeah, absolutely. That was why I was so excited to join you today. So thank you for having me. Actually, Kimberly was referencing how in your career, you need to really talk to people who are going to make you a better person in your career. And I feel like one of those people for me is you. So here we are together speaking today, which is pretty cool. At Team Bespoke, we work with a number of DTC brands. And so our goal today is really to give you some concrete examples that hopefully you can walk away with and really put some new tactics into place. Some of the brands we work with are Outdoor Voices, Urban Stems, Fenty Beauty, in fact, all of the Kendo brands, Lunya, on the food side, Hue Kitchen, Ollie Vitamins, Carbon 38, Entire World. There's a bunch, but
quite
we really
a list.
Like to work with brands that we like to work with folks who are excited to do new things in the space, right? I feel like we'll talk about how affiliate is, you know, really morphing and changing. And we definitely like to work with folks who are always on the forefront. So, but now let me introduce you, Jennifer. So Jennifer is one of the most respected and award-winning talents in the affiliate marketing industry. I'm going to make you blush now, but it's true. She's really well-respected. She's built relationships across the entire ecosystem. That's with publishers, agencies, networks and advertisers. And her role is really to work directly with those partners to grow her team's portfolio at Honey. She negotiates higher commissions, presents new products and technologies, and proposes new advertising campaigns. Her past experience includes working at an agency, PMX, at a couple of different publishers, coupons.com and Brad Steele's. And through all of those, she's really had a couple of successful exits as well, including Honey's acquisition by PayPal.
Oh, yeah, a very exciting one, especially PayPal. Well, thank you so much, Melissa. I appreciate that. We know that many of you are joining us from different types of brands, so we want to be sure to make the content today as relevant as possible. Because Melissa and I have been in the affiliate industry for an incredibly long time, we've learned that you always need to start with a definition of what is affiliate marketing. Melissa, do you want to start us off?
Sure. I mean, we've been in this industry since 2004. And so sometimes I still feel like it's quickly, like hard to define it quickly, but I will try my best. So Affiliate is a great tool that fits within an overall digital marketing mix. I feel like lately it's been termed a little more of a partnership channel, but at its core, I think it's defined as a way to distribute your brand to partner sites. You create a payment relationship that is on a CPA basis or cost per acquisition, so only when someone buys something, and you pay out a commission to the partner sites, and that can range anywhere from 5 to 15% usually. So you can look at your affiliate channel as driving both conversion as well as sort of top of funnel discovery. And that kind of depends on the partners that you're working with. And when you look at the channel overall as part of your marketing mix, I think it should represent between 10 and 25% of your overall online sales. That's a pretty big range. So it's that depends where you fall in that range. It's kind of like, do you have physical stores? How much do you discount? Do you sell on Amazon? Things like that. And so those can kind of dictate kind of where you fall there. But on the DTC side, I find that many of our clients come to us for affiliate as a way to diversify spend beyond social. They feel like they've become really reliant on that channel. And obviously there have been a lot of changes lately. And so they're like, what can we do to make up some gaps in our social performance? And how can we look to affiliate to do that? It's always a very cost-efficient channel. It should be one of your most cost-efficient channels, potentially just behind email. So it's definitely a great place to look for growth. And as we go through the presentation today, we're going to talk about some specific examples of how to run your program.
Great. And I think, you know, one thing you touched on, what I personally love about the affiliate channel is the human aspect. We rely on really strong relationships between advertisers and publishers, but most importantly, the consumers. So we hold like what we do right. We want to make it right for the business. But at the same time, really understanding your customer holds most of the value to achieve success. So it's a distinct difference from most other channels you will run. It requires relationships and a network of connections to run a best in class program. So definitely. And now that we've defined our space, why don't we talk about how Honey sees ourselves as a leader within it? So when you bark upon an affiliate marketing program, you'll have a few partners who are big like Honey and reliable revenue generators such as Honey. And then you'll likely have some smaller strategic partners as well. And today we wanna be sure that you learn about the partnership with Honey and what it can bring to your brand.
Yeah, I mean, I feel like Honey is a partner that can drive volume. You know, for our clients, the options for driving growth that can really make up a gap in social are pretty limited. There aren't a lot of places to turn for scale, right? So Honey is one lever you can tap into. There are 29 million members of Honey who have opted in and asked for Honey to provide them the best price. So, but one thing I think it would be great to start out, since this is mostly a DTC audience, is to talk about when we say best price, please don't always think discounting. I think that's partly why we gave this session the title we did. We know that many DTC brands don't love to discount heavily. So if you can find something that's true to your brand, but also communicate, this is the best price. I feel like that's what a Honey user really wants to see. So Jen, when I hear brands say, I'm scared to work with Honey because they need a deep discount, what would you say to that?
I would say, I would put my sales hat on and I would say, of course, we would love a 20% off coupon for your brand, but that's absolutely not required. It can be as simple as sharing your brand's key promo dates and any generic codes that the brand has already in use. And really from there, we can discuss all the different opportunities that Honey can offer and that fits each individual brand. We have a dedicated accounts team that works closely with our advertisers and helping find what's best for their KPIs and strategy. And we also have the most amazing content team that will add offers pretty quickly. I think you've seen that, Melissa. And of course, our users love exclusive offers, but we're absolutely willing to work with each individual brand to drive success in whatever way is really mutually beneficial to both advertiser and Honey.
Cool. Well, I referenced that you're one of the few options that really has scale to drive volume. How many users do you have and how many merchants do you work with?
Good question. So Honey is an end-to-end online shopping platform, and we're trusted by over 29 million members, as you've said, and we help save time and money. And we also help brands drive sales. So we have a full product suite that works as an optimization ecosystem at each stage of the consumer journey, from discovery to purchase, with specific products like Honey Gold, offers, store tips, that do a lot of the heavy lifting to engage and reward our shoppers. And our solutions help partners attract new customers and foster loyalty that keeps them returning to your store. So I'll share a couple really cool, exciting stats. As I said above, Honey has 29 million users. As you said earlier, we were acquired by PayPal over a year and a half ago. PayPal has 392 million active accounts. So big numbers and very exciting for the future with Honey and PayPal. Honey is partnered with over 10,000 stores. Honey drives 600 million monthly GMV to our advertisers, and Honey drives higher conversion. So shoppers using Honey are 166.6% more likely to make a purchase than a shopper who visits the brand's website and didn't use Honey.
I think that's a pretty impressive statistic.
It is. That's why I like to say it, pull it out, you know, when it's important.
I love it. Well, let's get into the consumer a little bit. Do you skew more male or female? And how do you guys kind of think about and define a typical Honey user?
So we have a very healthy mix of both male and female, which is a little bit unusual for the, you know, the loyalty coupon space, but it's also exciting. So we engage with a very unique demographic of millennials. They over-index on income and education. And so the value proposition of these interactions is really less about discounting and more about time savings and convenience. So for them, the message is really feeling good, being smart and savvy about making a purchase, and they want it now. So they know that Honey has their back. Over the last few years, we've seen an enormous amount of user growth. In the last year, we started acquiring users predominantly around social media, but have expanded to podcast sponsorships, YouTube influencer campaigns, Spotify ads, and even TV ads. And we also are on work with the LA Clippers. We've got an incredibly robust user acquisition and growth team that's leading the charge there.
I mean, as example, what we saw at the beginning of the talk with the influencer campaigns you ran, you had so many influencers who have supported downloading Honey, which I think is really fun.
Absolutely.
So I know you guys recently conducted a consumer study, and I feel like in these times, we are all sort of craving some recent consumer data. So Jennifer and I thought it might be fun to highlight some of the stats from the study that Honey did. Honey commissioned Atomic Research to survey more than 2,000 customers. So a pretty good sample size there.
Yeah.
And I'll start with one piece of data that kind of reinforces that what we kind of know about the pandemic, but 69% of respondents said that they had been online shopping more during the pandemic. Not so much of a surprise. We've seen that a lot. But there was a really unique data point that came out of it that really gets into some consumer psychology. And I feel like those of us in marketing, many of us are fortunate to have retained our jobs through the pandemic. And, you know, we sort of sit in our land of data where all we see is sales going up and up and up in e-commerce.
Right.
And we kind of forget what's, you know, really happening in the world. So 58% of respondents said they had experienced a decrease in household income since the start of the pandemic.
Wow.
I think that's a pretty powerful statistic, is really reminding us, you know, I feel like DTC brands are great at the connection with the consumer, asking a lot about what product enhancements do they want and things like that. But when we want to meet the consumer where they are, thinking about value in these times is actually kind of important. And again, that doesn't have to be a discount. It can be in a way that's authentic to the brand. But as you think about people having a decrease in household income, I think, you know, figuring out that that might be the new normal for a little while is
right.
Something that, you know, sort of changes your strategy a little bit. And there were a couple more things in the survey that I liked that were talking about the actual, like, they're scared to pay full price. So they talked about paying full price can lead to anxiety, frustration, and guilt. And 61% of respondents said they feel buyer's remorse within a few hours of making a full price purchase. So these stats are part of why I think it makes sense for a brand in the DTC space to work with Honey in these times. It shows that you care about getting consumers the best price, even if that's just some Honey gold that helps them feel like they got a real value, even if it's not a discount.
No, absolutely. And I think you left out two very important stats from the research. I know 62% of Americans experienced FOMOOD, which is fear of missing out on deals, instead of FOMO, FOMOOD. So fear of missing out on deals, I love that. And then when they chose not to buy a discounted item, they see and want. And then 75% of parents believe that getting a good deal is a sign of being a good mom and dad. And I thought that was super interesting. I was terrible at deals before I got into the deals space. And now I'm really, really good. So it's true. It's all true. Melissa, so how do you advise clients to think about their offer mix with Honey?
Sure. I mean, I think you have to think about the best offer for each type of partner that you have in the affiliate program. I mean, for Honey, this offer is likely going to get the most redemptions of any offer you have out there digitally. I mean, besides maybe email or search, but I mean, this is going to get a lot of redemptions. So you have to be strategic, right? You have to think about how is this going to affect your margins? What products do I really want to move? And really lay it out and think about that. And then you also have to think about conversion. I mean, Jennifer talked about that statistic at the beginning that, you know, folks who use Honey convert at 166% higher rate. So Honey is really the conversion push for consumers. And again, this is, you know, it's always fun in these talks, you know, to get slightly, I don't know, I'll call a spade, but controversial, I don't know.
Sure.
But sometimes I get into conversations with direct-to-consumer clients and I really push them on this because they'll say, you know, am I paying twice? Is Honey incremental and things like that? And I really believe that it is. And I think DTC brands spend a lot of money driving that top of funnel traffic. I mean, I think they're the best at really figuring out that social algorithm and getting people right to the site. But at the end of the day, you get 100 people to the site. Even the best brands probably have 92% of those people leaving, right? I mean, the conversion rate top maybe 8%, industry average 2 to 4. So that means of those 100 people who are arriving, you know, somewhere between 92 and 98 of them are leaving. And so why not use a tool like Honey in order to convert those folks? Honey is an expert at it. They give their users confidence if they haven't been to your brand before that it's a great site to buy from. So I really love having Honey in the mix in order to really push a consumer to convert.
And I love that. And I didn't even pay you for that. So thank you. That was amazing. I really appreciate that. I think it's important for people to hear that because I do think sometimes because of the volume that Honey drives, the first question is, what are they doing? Are they doing something that isn't working for us? Are we able to do this without them? So I appreciate that. I have another question. So how have you used Honey to add value to some of your clients currently?
Sure. Again, talking about how it's a major volume driver, I'll talk about three tactics. I could go on and on, but I'll pull out three. So one is increasing AOV, average order value. Second is to test offers. And my example is going to be with a new brand. And the third is to give Honey an exclusive offer in order to really drive volume in a pinch. So first, average order value. So we had a beauty client whose average order value was around $50 on Honey, and they really wanted to increase that. So we were gonna try and get it to 60. We gave Honey an exclusive offer that was a gift with purchase. I'm sure many of you, if you are beauty brands on the phone, probably know that every beauty brand's got a closet with some good stuff in it that you can make into a GWP. So we were able to do that, create an exclusive GWP for Honey users for this brand. And we were able to run it for a month and increase that AOV to $60 as we wanted to. And it's a lever that they've been able to pull over time as they've had some, you know, sort of excess inventory that they wanted to turn into an exclusive offer. We've used that repeatedly, which I think is kind of cool.
Awesome.
Yeah. The second example is testing offers. So we launched with a brand that launched their entire brand, you know, with affiliate right from the launch, really in order to capture a lot of PR tracking at the time. But we also had Honey in the program and we used Honey to test consumer offers. So they were, you know, they didn't want to be sending out a ton of emails because they were building their email list, right? They didn't have a lot of places to test offers. And so we used Honey to test those offers. So we tested buy one, get one, we tested free shipping, dollar off, percentage off, and they used that learning across their site, across a number of channels. So why not tap into Honey scale in order, you know, as you're a new brand, to really learn what will resonate with your consumers to actually convert them, which was kind of fun.
I love it.
And then my last example is kind of one of the reasons we chose this title for this talk. But, you know, obviously lately there have been a lot of changes in the algorithms on social. And some brands have whizzed on through and some have really struggled, you know, and the things that used to work for them, you know, haven't. And that happened to one of our clients in the fashion space. They're out fundraising. They need to be delivering to these goals that they set for monthly revenue. And they were kind of panicked. They're like, well, we get this worked out. What can we do? How can you help us? And so I said, I think we can turn to Honey. They are not a promotional brand. They only discount during Cyber Week usually. And so they were definitely very cautious to do something site-wide. And so I said, you know, Honey is, I don't want to call it like subtle, but I mean, it is a way to not, you know, put an offer directly out to your site or email. That's a way to get conversion using a discount. So we gave Honey an exclusive 20% discount for 1 week. It ended up making up a gap, an incremental gap over what Honey usually generated of between $500 and $1,000 a day. And that made a huge difference to them while they worked on their social algorithms and sort of figured it out. So there was a couple of rough weeks and we helped get them back on track. So again, I could give you many more examples, but I feel like you can chat with us in a Q&A. We've got questions at the end or connect with either one of us on LinkedIn. We're happy to continue.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah. Cool. Awesome. Well, Jen, I feel like I talked about all these sort of business problems in a way that Honey can help DTC brands solve. Can you kind of walk through the actual technology that Honey uses and the different features you have so that the brands can really learn how to optimize their engagement with consumers?
Yeah, absolutely. So as I said earlier, the Honey platform is an end-to-end shopping experience. So there's interaction at all stages of the shopping, including consideration, conversion, and retargeting. And we engage with users to message them about price changes, which is our drop list, loyalty points, which is our Honey Gold, and then coupon codes, which is just like literally a branded, whatever code you want, throw Honey in front of it. And this is always an effort to give them the confidence to buy now. So I'll walk you through a few of our key products. We have a lot, and so I won't bore you with all of them, but I'll start off with the one most people who know Honey are very familiar with. It's our Savings Finder, and it was our silver bullet into the space. It was created to take the friction out of the online shopping, and our goal was to create a seamless and easy experience for users. And this resulted in keeping users on the brand's page, which in return reduced cart abandonment rates and cross-site shopping and a whole lot more.
Yeah, I think that is what you're most famous for.
Yeah, absolutely. And then from there, our products have really evolved over the past 8 years. On our joinhoney.com, our site where we are interacting with users at every touch point, we're not only the kings at the point of conversion, but we're initiating journeys as well. And we see 50 million visits to Join Honey a month. And then 16 million of these visits are unique. And in fact, more than half of these visits are direct type-in traffic. So this means that about 8 million users are starting their shopping journey with Honey. And this is really incredible. And it shows we are no longer a browser extension only publisher, which I love reiterating, because I think for so long, that's what everyone, you know, talked about Honey, or, oh, you're just a browser extension. And we just have so much more to offer than that too. So I'll go into our Honey Gold. So Honey Gold is our points-based loyalty program where members can earn Honey Gold points on eligible purchases and you get to redeem gift cards. And so Honey Gold presents a gamification that resonates really well with our Honey's millennial users. I love redeeming my points for gift cards as well. And I'm definitely not a millennial. So I think it works for everybody. And it also works well with non-promotional brands because it's a point-based system. It doesn't devalue a brand. And Honey Gold works well for incentivizing to get the user to convert, and promotional brands as that added cherry on top. So it has proven to significantly reduce cross-site shopping and increase conversion rates, which is awesome.
Honey Gold's something I get a lot of questions about from clients. Can you sort of talk a little bit about how dynamic it is?
Sure. So let's say one of your makeup brands is in a slow month, but they still want Honey Gold on. We would make sure to have it at one to five to make sure that the brand doesn't lose the loyal Honey Gold customers. But at a time when it's really important to drive more revenue, when you have holidays coming and you have some amazing gift with purchase. So then you would ask us to increase, and it could be anywhere from 1 to 20, maybe 1 to even 30%, dependent upon what the brand is looking for, where it's really dynamic. So even if it's a short term where they have an offer that they really want to push and they only want to pay for, you know, 10 days, we're able to go in and update that and make that work for them so that we can really help push and drive more revenue for them.
That's great. I feel like that happens a lot in the DTC world. They're like, okay, let's do a Memorial Day weekend sale and we need you for the next 7 days, something higher. Yeah.
Absolutely. And we don't need much time. So, you know, we've had many times where they're like, we really need this done now, and we can absolutely go in and make that happen. So it's pretty awesome, and it's worked well for our advertisers. So, and then we have, I know you and I have talked a lot about it, but not everyone else knows about it, but Honey Offers, which is super exciting. And it's our exclusive bonuses that are presented to our users while browsing specific products on the advertiser's site. So it's creating a call to action at the point of consideration. And this leads to increase in conversions and store revisits, plus a reduction in in comparison shopping, which we've talked about. And these feel really like personalized individual offers. And it's fun for the advertiser because it controls, you know, a really fun and exciting interaction with the user. And they're able to really decide, you know, where and what they want to push and what they're looking for. So we're seeing enormous increases in conversion rates and return on purchases. I have a few stats from our Honey offers. And really what we've seen so far is about a 333% average lift in conversion rate after activating an offer. 87% greater chance of revisiting a store within the 7-day window of an offer redemption. And then a 38% lift in 30-day to new customer repurchase rate, which is a return visit and purchase, which is huge.
Yeah, absolutely. I was literally just talking to a client about that, like the time to the second purchase and how important that is for them. And we talked about how you can really use Honey for it.
Yeah, no, absolutely. And I think, you know, one thing I don't have on here is drop list. Drop list is one of my very, you and I both love drop list.
Yes, we
do. So drop list is where a customer can go in and say, oh my God, I love that makeup. I really want that lipstick, but it's $65. It's ridiculous. On my budget, I can't afford it. They can go and put in a price that they're looking for. So if there's ever a sale on that particular item, we will shoot an email and notify them. And the open rate for that email is about 60%. So we're really seeing huge success with our drop list, and it'll just continue to get better and better.
That's awesome.
Yeah. Okay. And I think we're getting close to time. So we're gonna show one more video, and then I think we have about maybe 8 to 10 minutes to ask questions. So if we could get Ravina to play the sizzle video, we can do that. And then we can follow up with questions. And if there's not time for questions, or if anyone doesn't have a question right this minute, as Melissa said, we are more than happy to have you reach out to us on LinkedIn, email, whatever works. We're always excited to help people get involved in affiliate marketing because we're both so passionate about it. And we definitely want to see more people begin to drive revenue and see how amazing this space is.
Meet Honey. We're a better way to buy. We help stores reach more customers who buy more often through a suite of features that work together across the shopping journey. JoinHoney.com is where members discover stores, products, and some of the best deals. Same goes for the mobile app. Members can follow stores, explore products, and more. Members love our browser extension. When they shop on different sites, Honey searches for coupons, and with one click, applies the best one we find. We even top it off with more reasons to buy. Honey Gold is our loyalty program where members earn gold. Gold they can redeem for rewards. When members get to a store's homepage, they can earn gold on products throughout the site. On product pages, they can earn bonus gold on that product through limited time offers. We turn shoppers into buyers through a universe of shopping features that all add up to more business. A better way to buy starts with a better partner. Honey.
Oh, and no technical glitches. This is amazing. It's huge. Melissa, I was going to say, if you want to take a look at some of these questions, I feel like several of the first ones are definitely, I feel like, better for you to answer, especially because you are running with these advertisers.
Yeah, most definitely. Cool. One of the first questions here says, when you think of your DTC strategy in terms of finding new customers and keeping your brand loyalists, what role does data play? Customer acquisition, lapsed customers. So definitely, I feel like in the programs that we run, you look at your affiliate program like your 401k plan. You know, you need a lot of different elements to it. And so there are certain publishers that drive a lot of new customers, and there are certain publishers who drive more conversion or repeat purchase. What I will say is that it also depends on where your brand is in its life cycle. So if you're a brand new brand, for many of our clients who launch, and we launch with Honey, of course, it's like between 70 and 90% new customers coming through Honey for the first like year. You know, I think that can last at higher than 60% new customers through Honey for the first 3 years or so. And then after that, once you become a little bit more mature as a brand, you're going to hover between 50 and 60. But I think that Honey will drive both new customers and repeats during that time. So what role does data play? I mean, everybody's got a different data story, right? And I think you can slice and dice an analysis paralysis to a certain point. And then you just also have to, you know, again, think about that consumer mindset and where are they and meeting them. And they don't think in terms of the channels. They don't think in terms of the touch points and stuff. So you just have to say, okay, I'm investing holistically across my marketing channels this much. It's going to pay out. You know, you don't get to a point where you're not making money across all of them, but affiliate's always going to be so efficient. It's going to fuel other places you can test. So use it in that way, I would say. I mean, do you have specific stats on new customers? I mean, you guys are investing so much in user acquisition. I feel like
we are
always really fueling new customers.
We are, and we're really focused. What we've, you know, we've gone out and talked to our advertisers and said, you know, what's most important to you, and really what's most important to them is new users, new to file users. And so we work very hard. Honey offers, that's something that we really are seeing a lot of new to file on. There's lots of ways, especially as we integrate more and more with PayPal, when we're able to do more with them, I think we'll continue to be able to do just that, to drive that. So we definitely have amazing reporting that is exciting, because I think for so many years I've been in the space, and let's be clear, Melissa, there hasn't been a lot of great reporting. So reporting is getting better and better. I think we're all starting to really understand what the advertiser needs and what their wants are. And reporting is how they really are able to calculate their KPIs and how they're able to grow. And so it's important for us to be able to offer and deliver that to them.
That's awesome. Cool. Another question came in about what are some of the, or one of the most considerable benefits of launching a DTC brand is owning the relationship with your customers. So what are some of the challenges of owning this relationship? You know, I think you have to be a steward of that, right?
Yep.
But do you want to start that one, or do you want me to?
I think you go ahead and start, and then I'll follow up for sure.
Yeah, I think when you think about how to sort of help that customer understand your brand, I always try and think of it in kind of a product life cycle. So as you come up with new products, can you guide them along sort of that journey? So there's a couple of ways to present those in the affiliate channel. You can do that through some content sites, you know, get an article in InStyle about that new product. And then you can also do that with a partner like Honey, where you're saying some of this offers and Honey Gold sort of coordination, where you're like, for these new products, we're actually going to actually offer more Honey Gold on those products in order to show consumers how much you want to purchase those. I would say that might be one answer to that question.
Yeah, absolutely. I love that. And I also think another thing that we didn't really speak a whole lot on is, you know, something that Honey hasn't done in the past and we're starting to do is we're doing a lot with influencers. And so we're offering that to our advertisers. And we started doing newsletters. So there are so many different opportunities and way to test with Honey outside of Honey Offers, outside of Find Savings, outside of Honey Gold. So it's really giving you know, the advertiser or who wants to run this brand, the opportunity to decide what works best. It's not, you know, one size fits all. Everyone's different. Everyone has their own wants and their own needs. And, you know, there's certain brands that have such tight margins, and we have to be really thoughtful when we come in. We can come in and do like, listen, we can lay this out for you all on. We'll turn it all on. Well, that's going to blow their budget. And then they're going to have to cut back on, you know, 90% of the other publishers out there that they're working with. That doesn't work. So it's really having open and honest dialect and conversations and taking the time to understand, you know, what the advertiser is looking for and what they need. And our goal isn't a short-term goal. It's long-term. We want long success with these advertisers to trust in us and to know that, oh, you know what? Honey is someone I can go to when I need to offload something that we bought too many things of, or when I want to do something that, you know, it didn't sell as much as we had hoped it would. And here we are. We're always here to, you know, to pull as many levers as we can.
Very cool. This next one really talks about the audience demographics and expanding that to be more inclusive. Like how is essentially the affiliate audience expanding as the industry grows and evolves? And I think that's a really good one because it definitely has. And I think, you know, partners like Honey, because of the investment you've done to get to the real younger consumer, have been really interesting. But a lot of our DTC clients are really coastal in their audience. So definitely have a huge audience in New York and the East Coast, and then California tends to be LA, especially if they're, you know, fashion and beauty focused, which many of our clients are. Right. And so I think the affiliate channel really mirrors a lot of that same demographic. And so it allows you to reach those consumers really effectively. I'll let you talk about Honey specifically, but I can talk about some other folks. But like, if you think about the media publications, which is Condé Nast and Vox Media and New York Mag and stuff like that, they're a great way to kind of reach consumers there. And then the other thing we've seen as super effective is influencers too.
Absolutely.
When brands do direct deals with influencers and, you know, really sort of build out a strategy there, we've been able to really marry the influencers audience with the brand's audience in a way that really helps ensure sales. But I'll
exactly.
talk specifically about Honey.
Well, and that's what I was going to say too. So that's exactly right. You're so on point with that. So we do have so many influencers that we work with. And so we're able to say, you know, tell us what does your audience look like? Who would make the most sense for you to work with? We certainly don't want a brand to waste money and not make sure that we've really set them up for success. So we have our growth team. We've just have so many new opportunities that we're able to share with all of these advertisers that I'm excited, as you can tell. I'm super excited about it. And I think we're always going to be thoughtful with who we're working with, what their target audience is, and how we make that work. Yes, we have millennials, which is incredibly unusual in this space. So most brands have been so excited to work with us because they hadn't gotten in front of the millennials. And now it was about like brand recognition. And so we've done that. And now that we're with PayPal, we have so many other users, you know, to get them in front of, which is very exciting. So again, we can, you know, work on a newsletter campaign. We can work on with influencers. And then there's a lot of other ways we can really sit down and strategize exactly what and how that will look for them.
I love it. That's very cool. I think our last question kind of is an interesting one. It talks about, are there any potential trigger points that are holding you back from taking your strategy to the next level, or at least the level you were at prior to the pandemic? And I think for many of our brands, it's been supply chain.
Yeah, right.
So
we all know that's a problem.
Honestly, it's been, you know, the stuff's not coming off the boats. The stuff's not getting to the warehouse in Kansas City.
Right.
And there's been insane demand. One of our beauty clients had a TikTok video go viral in March. They rebranded. They had this viral TikTok video and it sold out in a week. I mean, the brand hit their like insane goals so quickly. And they can't get the stuff back until June and August. They like literally can't get it, you know, made fast enough. And actually, yeah. Kimberly was talking about that on the prior session, just like, what could our year have looked like if we'd had all that supply at Kimberly?
I know. And I think everyone has felt like that, right? If no one has a crystal ball. No one knew we had a pandemic on the horizon, right? So we weren't prepared. But now maybe we will be prepared. This is maybe the first. And so we're going to think a lot differently. And we've all been very successful working from home, which is something that you and I've worked from
you
home.
You were a pioneer of that long before all of us.
I was a pioneer. I have to tell you, I didn't like you all at home. I preferred you all in the office. But I do think it works really well. We've seen that motivated workers have goals and they can actually get a lot accomplished when, you know, waking up, taking a shower and going to their kitchen counter, whatever that looks like to everyone. But I think we are almost out of time.
I think so. Well, I'll just wrap it up with that inventory question and say, as brands get more careful with their inventory, I do think Honey is a place, if you ever overbuy, the place to definitely partner with in order to
we'll always help
move through it as the industry.
We are, absolutely. We're here to help you. But thank you so much for joining, Melissa. And thank you, Izzy, for having us. It was a really fun conversation and we're always happy to be here. So thank you.
Yeah, thank you both for joining us. I'm a Honey user myself, so always
glad to hear it.
Yeah, to see